Hello everyone, welcome you all in today's my class. In today's class, we will proceed our history chapter 5, that is colonialism and tribal society, with next topic. And in today's video, I will explain tribal revolt. Okay, so in my previous video, I already explained the British wanted the tribals to settle in one place, so that it would be easier for them to control us. They introduced land settlements for a regular supply of revenue. Okay, so reason is this type of settlement is one place, so that it would be easier for them to control us. They introduced land settlement for a regular supply of revenue. So forest were a source of livelihood for the tribals. Okay, and so the forest laws formulated by the Britishers. So first, the Britishers are formulated forest laws. Okay, so forest were, we know very well, forest were a source of livelihood for the tribals, and so the forest laws formulated by the British had a significant impact on their lives. The British declared all forests as state property and classified certain forests as reserved, and the tribals were not allowed to cultivate, hunt or gather fruits in these areas. This forced many of the tribals to move to other places in search of livelihood and created a scarcity of labors for the British. Some tribals were allocated small patches of land near the forest for cultivation, and in return asked to work for the British. The tribals eventually protested against these laws. The revolt of Songkhram. Songkhram Sangama. Okay. Sangama in Assam. This revolt was begun in Assam in 1906, during 1906, and the forest satyagraha in the central provinces in 1930. Okay. So the central provinces in 1930 were two such major revolts against the British. So it also affected the lives of tribal greatly, as they were exploited by moneylenders and traders. By the 19th century, many traders and moneylenders started coming to the forests for purchasing forest produce, offering loans and obtaining cheap labors. So the 19th century saw many tea plantations and mines coming up in different parts of India. Since the forests were now under the British, many tribal were forced to leave their homes and work in these plantations and coal mines. The British rule also affected tribal chiefs. The chiefs enjoyed administrative and economic power earlier, but now had to follow the rules laid down by the British, pay tributes to the British officers, and stop practicing their traditional functions. So that's our impact of tribal society during colonialism and colonization period by Britishers. So I hope you all understood well all topics of this chapter. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग. हैव अ गुड डे.